Something has to break. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Yes, something has to break. Whatever it is, it's got to break up off of you right now in the name of Jesus. The spirit of depression, the spirit. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. It has to go right now in the name of Jesus. Whatever it is you've been believing God for. The joy back. Your strength back. Your hope back. Thank you, Lord. In the name of Jesus. The spirit of sickness and disease. Something has to break if the Lord is there. Listen, when the spirit of the Lord is moving, everything's got to go. Ooh, thank you, Lord Jesus. We thank you for your presence, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Ooh. Hallelujah. Amen, amen. Well, good morning, I am. Amen, amen. Ooh, amen,
amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Well, you can go ahead and be seated, amen.
Ooh, y'all know I get emotional about that song right there, so forgive me for a minute.
Amen. Amen. Well, good morning, everyone. How's everybody doing this morning? How's everybody doing this morning? Amen, 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 amen. Well, welcome to I Am Church, where Jesus Christ is Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And today is the day that the what?
Lord has made.
And we all going to what?
Rejoice.
And be what?
Glad in it.
Amen, amen. Well, I'm Pastor Al. This is my lovely wife, Pastor Noel. We
Thank
are
you,
glad
Jesus.
For you to be in the house of the Lord this morning. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. We're glad to see you guys where we
Thank
do
you,
ministry
Jesus.
And life.
Together.
For we walk by
faith
and not by
sight.
Amen, amen, and
amen.
People, and people online, we like to say welcome, welcome, welcome. We look forward to seeing you guys one day in the church house. Amen. One
amen.
Day in the church house. We look forward to seeing you guys in the church house, and we're gonna be glad to get to fellowship with you. Not hug you all the way sometime, but maybe shake your hand, give you a dap pad, but until you're fully ready to come fully back. But we're ready to just a fellowship. Which sometimes it's good to have fellowship. Amen. Sometimes this corona thing had us all spaced out, not saying nothing and talking from a distance, but sometimes it's good for good fellowship. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Say, amen.
Amen. So if you're online, go ahead and share. Go ahead and share our page. Go and share our page. Let them know that we're now online. Also, let people know that, if you're online and say, let us know what city and state you're in. I know we got Miss Teresa. She's in Pittsburgh. So let us know you're in Pittsburgh. Miss Belinda, she's in Chicago. Let us know you're from Chicago. Amen. Let us know what's going on in your
Janae
parts
in
of the
California.
World. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Janae in California.
Miss Janae in California. Miss Janae, hello, hello. You in California. But, you mean, we'd like to just say welcome, welcome, welcome to I Am Church for all the visitors that's in-house and also online. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So today we're going to have a special presentation. Amen. This is something that's going to be a little hard for us all. Everyone know that our brother Freddie has gone on to be with the Lord. Tonight we're going to have a special service for him tonight. For anyone who has comments as far as here at I Am or anyone that's outside of I Am, you like have a special comment because we're not going to do any special comments on tomorrow evening for the actual service. But so if you want to have any, we're going to have music, we're going to have a dance, special stuff going on. We have comments going on tonight, a special words that you have, you know, that how Freddie blessed in your life. So if you'd like to be a part of that, that'll be today at 5 p.m. So if you'd like to be a part of that, go ahead. If you're not going to be able to be here, you can send me or Pastor Noel a text, and we can read your messages also for you. Amen. So we'd like you to be a part of that if you'd like to be a part of that. Amen. Well, so what we're going to do, we're going to do a special song. I have George getting ready for it. This is a special song that we have for, we know Brother Freddie, he loves this song. So we're going to do just something to honor Freddie. Amen.
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 Yep.
Vamos!
Getting weary. How far is heaven? And I know that I need to change my ways of living. How far is heaven? Lord, can you tell me? I've been locked up way too long in this crazy world. How far is heaven? And I just keep on praying, Lord, and just keep on living. How far is heaven?
Yeah, Lord, can you tell me?
How far is heaven?
I just gotta know how far, yeah.
How far is heaven?
Yeah, Lord, can you tell me?
I'm living. How far is heaven? And I just got to have some faith and just keep on giving. How far is heaven?
Yeah, Lord, can you tell me?
How far is heaven?
I just gotta know how far, yeah.
How far is heaven?
Yeah, Lord, can you tell me?
How far?
I just gotta know how far.
I just wanna know how far.
Songs that Freddie he enjoyed was How Far From Heaven. Amen. 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 Come on, get the lights for us. Somebody get the lights for us, please.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Amen. Somebody get the lights. The lights. Amen. Amen. If everyone cannot bother the sound department until, you know what I mean, talk to everyone. The sound time is not time to bother the sound department when service is going on. I got too many things they got going on. Amen. Amen. So, yeah, so what we have now, we have a special presentation now. You want to call Miss Kathy, or do you want me to call Miss Kathy, or do you want me to call you baby girl?
Well, both of y'all.
Come on, come on, both of y'all come
both
up.
Both of y'all come up.
Come on, both of y'all come up. Amen.
Amen.
Special presentation. Amen.
Amen.
Everyone know this is Christiana. Come over here, Christiana. Come
I know.
Yeah, this is Miss Christiana. This is baby girl, amen. Everybody know Pastor Kathy, amen.
Yes, amen.
Amen, amen. Amen. So the I Am family, we want to do something special for you guys today to celebrate my best friend and also Pastor Freddie. So Miss Shannon, can you bring that up for me, please? This is just for the service here, so for the ones who will come tonight. This is a plaque. I'm going to have Pastor Noel present it to you. You can read it to her.
It says, in loving memory. Freddie Chavez, 1972 to 2021. It says, you will be missed today and every day. From now until the end of time, with all our hearts, we loved you, and forever your light will shine.
Amen. So we present to you this from the I Am Church and the I Am Church family in memory of Freddie Chavez.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So we have some other pieces to it too, so we'll bring those to you later. All right, thank you guys.
You look beautiful. My niece.
Amen, amen. I want to ask Pastor Chase for all the ones who can't be able to make it tonight. Amen. Amen.
I don't know.
Amen. Well, let's go ahead and get into the word. Amen. We're going to get into the word. Everybody ready? Everybody got your Bibles, your iPads, your phones, whatever you have. Go ahead and get that ready. Amen.
All right, so just to lighten it up a little bit, y'all know if Freddie was here, he'd be like, y'all better pull it together because we got service. So we better pull it together before you, if it's possible, you make the camera fall out or something on us.
Amen.
Amen.
Everybody ready? Here we go. This is my Bible. I can do what it says I can do.
What it says I can do.
I am.
I am.
What it says I am.
Says I am.
I'm a believer and not a doubter.
Not a doubter.
I'm a doer.
I'm a doer.
And not just a hearer.
Not just a hearer.
And my life.
My life.
Is the better after having heard the word of faith. Faith comes by hearing. And hearing by.
And hearing by.
The word of God.
Word of God.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Go and be seated. Amen. Amen. So we're going to continue a lesson that me and Pastor Noel taught a couple weeks ago. We taught about a thing called Supernatural Faith, Part 1. Today's going to be Part 2 of that series. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So today we want you to understand what we talked about on Part 1. Faith is something. Faith believes in something. Faith says something. And faith does something. So today our focus is going to be to align our faith and continue building while our hearts and mouth and eyes and hands. How to align and continue building. How to align and continue building with our hearts, things that come out from our hearts, from our mouths, our eyes, and our hands. Amen?
Amen. Amen. So basically what we've been talking about, you know, we've been talking about supernatural faith, and sometimes to align with what the word of God says about us and our lives and our families' lives, it's going to take supernatural faith to do that, because as a human, we just can't think that. You know, the things that God has said to us and spoken to us about our lives and what he has for us, we can't even fathom that in our natural mind. So it does take supernatural faith. I'll define it again. It is supernatural faith is a manifestation of the Spirit whereby that which is uttered or desired by man or spoken by God shall eventually come to pass. So that's what it is. It's just knowing that it's going to happen. Supernatural faith is one thing when you say, okay, yeah, it might happen. But supernatural faith says, oh, I know it will because the word said it will. Yes. Yes. This is what the word says. Like we always say, it is written. It is written, because that's what's going to happen.
So let's go into our passage of the Bible in Luke chapter 6. Luke chapter 6, and that's verse 45. Luke 6, 45. And that's in the New King James Version. And if you don't have it in here, you can also look on the screens. Amen. Here we go. A good man out of the good treasure of his heart brings forth good. And an evil man out of the evil treasure of his heart brings forth evil. For out of the abundance of the heart, what? The mouth speaks.
The mouth speaks. So if you said it, that's what you meant. If it come out of your mouth, don't say, oh, that was just a slip of a tongue. Because that's what you've been thinking. That's what's been marinating on the inside of you if it comes out. Yeah. You know how they say, okay, y'all, don't be trying. Don't get super spiritual on me right now. You know how they say when people drink, when they drink and they had a few too many, how they say, oh, they start talking, oh, I was drunk, I didn't know what I was saying. Oh, you knew you were just out of control and you couldn't control your tongue, so you spoke what you really meant when you were drunk. So that's the same thing. What is in your heart? What is in your heart? What is in your mind? What is in your spirit? Whatever it is coming out of your mouth, that's what you've been thinking all along. So don't be saying, oh, I was just mad at you, I didn't mean none of that. Yes, you did. Because you've been thinking it for a while, but you just got a little liquid courage or angry courage to say it. So we have to get ourselves to the point where we believe God and we say, you know what? I'm not going to be thinking those evil things. Because if that's what you're thinking, that's what you're going to attract to. You know how they say the law of attraction? It's true. If you're thinking evil thoughts, it's going to come out your mouth, and that's what you're going to bring to yourself. If you're thinking good thoughts, then that's what you're going to bring, and that's what you're going to say, and that's what you're going to do.
Amen.
Amen.
That's why you definitely got to be careful.
Excuse me.
You definitely got to do a heart check.
Come on. I said Jesus.
Yeah. Do a heart check. People say, well, that, I didn't mean to say it. Yes, you did. Like Pastor Noel said, you did.
Uh-huh.
'Cause out of the abundance of the heart, what?
The mouth speaks.
The mouth speaks. So if you say, I know Dr. Craig did an analogy years ago about the Kool-Aid. It's red right now. So until you keep pouring water into it and you keep praying into it, it's going to dissolve until it becomes clear. But if you ain't putting nothing in there to make it become clear, it's going to keep exposing what's in there. So if you got cuss words in your vocabulary, guess what? Cuss words gonna keep coming out because you ain't checked your heart.
That's right. What now?
If you got a lot of things going on in your life and you ain't dealt with it, because why even dealt with it? Because it's still in your heart. And we're gonna explain some things later on why you gotta first deal with your heart.
Amen.
The heart is the key to everything.
Yes, it is.
Yep.
The heart is the key to everything.
Amen.
Let's look at Philippians chapter 4, 6 through 7. It says, don't worry about anything. Instead, pray about everything. Tell God what you need and thank him for all he has done.
All that he's done. So thank him for everything. When you hit the floor in the morning, I thank you, Lord, that I'm awake. I thank you, Lord, that I'm up. I thank you, Lord, that I can put my foot on the floor. I thank you, Lord, that I can walk. Even if something is hurting, don't dwell on that. Thank him for what you can do. Don't dwell on what you can't do. Thank him for everything. And then another thing, before you even ask God for something, thank him. You notice, have you ever thought about it? Sometimes we always want to ask God for this. Oh, God, deliver me from this. Oh, God, I need this. Oh, God, send me this. Oh, God, do this for me. When was the last time you thanked him? You know, Janet Jackson had a song called, what have you done for me lately? What have you done for God lately? While you asking him for everything, thank him for some stuff. Lord, I thank you. Now, in the process, you know, it's okay to ask for something. But thank him for what he's done. Even if it looked like he's not moving, even though it looks like he didn't do nothing, he did something because you're here. Mm-hmm. Amen.
And sometimes we go through life and we always want something, we want to keep asking.
Yeah.
Husbands, we keep asking our wives. Wives say, all you can do is just love me first. If you just love me first, then you can ask. All you got to do is just rub my head. Shake some stuff in my head, then you can ask.
Right.
But what you want the receiving portion first before you ask.
Right. That's
it. You got to put the work in. You got to put the work in. Because then when you put the work in, go to verse 7.
Yes.
When you put the work in, then you will what? Experience God's peace.
Yes.
Which exceeds anything we can what? Understand. Lord. His peace will guard your hearts and your minds as you live out in the Christ Jesus.
Thank you, Lord Jesus. So that's it. So we have to realize that. So if we do that correctly, God's peace. You want to have God's peace in everything. Have you ever tried to make a decision in your life where you did something and it just didn't sit right with you? Sometimes if you on point with God and you do it the way God is telling us to do it, you will have peace in every decision that you make in your life. You will have peace in every decision that you need to make. And some decisions you think you need to make, you don't have to make if you had the peace of God on you and kept your heart guarded. Because sometimes you get yourself, if you don't guard your heart, you get yourself worked up over something that don't even matter. Don't even matter. So we have to realize what we pray reveals what we believe. So if you praying, see, in the middle of a prayer, if you praying with praying to God and you say, if you're willing or if you will, don't even pray. Don't even do it. Because as soon as you say if, you don't believe him. So don't do it. Don't even do it till you can get that if. Or you know how they say when you talking and somebody is talking, they'll say, oh, you know what? That's a lovely shirt you have on today. But, okay, so after the but is always something that's something negative. When somebody say but, it's negativity coming after that. So if you say God, if, that's negativity.
Because remember this, because if you don't guard your heart, it's going to go straight to your what? Your mind.
Go straight to your mind.
Think. So yep. If you're not guarding your heart, it's going to taint your mind.
Yep.
It's going to taint your mind immediately.
That's right.
I have a quote here. It says, prayer is a blessing, not a burden.
Yep.
Prayer is a privilege, not a pressure.
Uh-huh.
Prayer is a work, but it brings joy.
Amen. And that's the thing. Here it is. Now, when it's time to pray, you know how sometimes it's a struggle. Whenever we say, you know what, let's pray this thing out, let's have a month of prayer, everybody be like, why we got to do all that? Don't nobody never want to do it. Then they'll question it. The thing is, it's never going to work if you question it every time somebody say do it. If we saying do it and God is saying do it, then let's just do it and see what happens.
Amen.
So sometimes that's why it's a struggle, because you was going to say something?
Go ahead, babe.
Okay. Because sometimes we need to be spending our time with God, but see, we let our minds go everywhere else. Mind go everywhere.
Amen. There's two areas
everywhere
why we can't get things in line.
Mm-hmm.
There's two areas why we can't get two things in line. Why does the devil mess with us when it's time to pray and when it's time to exercise?
Amen. What? Right?
He messes with you when you can't pray because he knows that's the key.
Right?
He know he can't mess with you if you don't exercise, because he know that affect everything with your body.
Mm-hmm.
And if your body is out of line and your prayer life is out of line, guess what's going to happen? Everything's going to affect. That's
yep.
In the spiritual realm and that's in the natural realm.
Uh-huh.
So if I can affect your prayer life, that's going to affect you in your spiritual realm.
That's right.
If I can affect you in your exercise and in your health, guess what? That's going to affect you in your natural realm.
Yep.
So if I can keep getting you to be on Netflix,
what I'm, now?
I got your mind.
Yeah.
So now you can't focus on prayer.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Go ahead, babe.
I was going to say, because like when you're watching Netflix, if it's a good show, okay, I'm going to tell y'all, I'm telling on myself, when the Game of Thrones, the first time I started watching it, I was like, oh, no, I won't say Game of Thrones. What was the first thing we watched?
Go do Game of
Sons
Thrones.
Sons of Anarchy.
Oh, that one too. Lord Jesus.
Man, they had a cliffhanger at the end of each and every one. We were like, oh, one more. You would stay up all night long watching the next one. But then when it's time to pray, we can't even give God 10 minutes. We sleepy. We tired, we sleepy, we hungry. I don't know what else to say, Lord. I don't have time. All right, I done gave him his little 5 or 10 minutes. Mm. That's all I need. Oh, because I got to get back to Game of Thrones.
What's important?
What's important? But see, that's the thing, because that's how the enemy will get you, because he knows that with prayer begins to get to the manifestation.
Yeah.
Because you ain't going to never receive your manifestation if you ain't in prayer. Mm. Got to be in prayer.
Also the natural side. You got to exercise. You got to exercise.
Yeah.
If you run up the street and you having a hard time breathing, guess what?
Woo.
You need some exercise.
I can't
do some jumping jacks. Do some push-ups.
Do
some sit-ups.
Like,
God can't work the full manifestation if you're not doing your part. You can keep praying and praying. God, I'm believing God for my healing, but God says, it's already done. All you got to do is exercise. All you got to do is get on my throne and pray.
Thank you, Jesus.
Well, how many people know there's going to always be distractions? You're going to start smelling stuff.
Yeah.
Oh, my wife done cooked some good old food. Lord Jesus, I didn't need an extra piece of gravy.
Oh, God.
I need some good old biscuits. Wow. Which I probably need some vegetables. Ugh.
I just want meat.
I just want meat. You got to focus. Then all of a sudden you start praying and stuff. All of a sudden you start thinking about food.
Yeah.
My wife happened to cook a certain meal while she know I'm about to pray. That's a distraction. My wife, I know she cooks at 5:00 every day. I need to move my prayer time to another time then. So I can't be distracted.
That's right. That's right.
How many people know when you start getting to prayer, the kids start acting up? Mama, mama, daddy, daddy. That's a distraction. If you know the kids need to be at 8:30, you got to put some discipline in them. 8:30, got to be in bed so I can get my prayer time at 8:45 with God. Yeah. Or in the morning before they wake up.
Yeah. Or the phone don't ring all day long. No ringing. Phone doesn't ring. Nobody come by. Nothing's going on till you about to spend time with God in prayer. Or in his word. Because once you study his word, once you're in there studying his word, prayer is coming. You ain't going to be able to study God's word and not pray. It's all together. It's a package deal.
It's all together.
So then it's always some kind of distraction. I know my phone barely rings. But as soon as I'm in the word or I'm trying to pray about something or somebody or something, then hear the phone ring. He talking to me. Mom don't never talk to me during the day, Harley, but she'll come in there. What you doing? You know what I'm saying? But that's how the enemy gets us off track. It's all distractions to stop us from the manifestation of what God has for us. Then we get mad at God like he didn't come through. Mm-hmm. We get mad and we're like, oh, God, you know, I've been praying for this for 20 years and you still haven't let me see the manifestation. Well, what have you done for him lately?
Yes. Come on now. Man. And that's why it's like, remember we talk about that series on Attack While Building. As soon as we started praying and praying things just started happening through the ministry.
Jesus.
Pastor Noel's father went on to be with the Lord, Freddie. Just a lot of stuff just started happening in the ministry.
It's
we almost had to postpone the thing last week because of things that was going on. It's like, Lord, what's going on? God said, you just attack while I build it.
Yep.
You just attack. You got to keep pressing on, Pastor Al. It's, no matter what goes on, keep pressing on.
Yeah.
You still got to keep moving forward, no matter what's going on.
Yeah.
Because I seen someone posted this online this week. Your calling, if not prepared and ready, will cost and crush you. Come on. Your calling, if not prepared and ready, will cost and crush you. Mm. If you are called to mend the brokenhearted, you're going to be wrestled with brokenheartedness.
Mm, Jesus.
If you're called to prophecy, you're going to struggle and struggle with controlling your mouth.
Mm.
If you're called to prophecy, you're going to struggle with controlling your mouth.
Jesus.
If you're called to laying of hands, you're going to struggle with spiritual viruses.
Jesus.
If you're called to preach and teach the gospel, you will be sifted in the wisdom and that anoints your message. And if you're called to empower, your esteem will be attacked while your success will be hard fought.
Jesus.
Your calling will come with cups, thorns, and shiftings that are necessary for your master to be authentic, humble, and powerful. Your crushing won't be easy because your assignment is not easy. So your oil is not cheap.
Not cheap. So we want you to remember today that we have to remember God's promises and the prayers that he's answered in the past. That's the thing. When you're waiting on manifestation, remember what he did for you in the past. Just go back to that. Refer back to that. If you can't remember, if you can't see it because you got something going on and everything is just so cloudy and all the distractions and all of the disease and everything that's just going on, go back to the past and remember what God did for you before when you needed him. especially in the same area, because that's a huge remedy for a lot of the difficult moments that we may experience right now. Remember that God is faithful. He is faithful. He will be there with us no matter what. He didn't say that the storms aren't going to come. He never said nothing was ever going to happen to us. He never said nothing devastating will ever happen. He did say that he'll be there with us, though. So that's what we have to remember. Bring to remembrance what God has done and what he's promised and what he'll do, and watch the peace of God come over you.
Amen. So Pastor Al and Noel, how do we get our faith in alignment with our hearts, with our mouths, with our eyes, and with our hands? How do we get our faith in alignment?
In alignment.
To restore alignment, you must come into alignment with God, Father God, first.
That's right.
So in other words, everything that you do in your life, you got to make sure God is in the center of it.
That's right.
Because if he's in the center of everything that's going on, then that's where you get first. You got to get yourself aligned.
Yes, that's right.
So the first thing you got to do is get your heart right, what we talk about. You got to get your heart right. If your heart's not right,
Jesus.
If your heart's not right.
Thank you, Jesus.
You are showing what God is doing in your life.
Jesus.
Because you are the what? The visible representation of the invisible God. So however your heart is connected to God. Mm-hmm. So if you're spooling out foolishness, maybe you might not be connected to God. You might
there
be connected to the other source, which
you
is the devil.
You definitely ain't connected to God.
Who are you really connected to?
What's in your spirit?
Who are you connected to in your heart?
Mm-hmm. So we must align our hearts with God's heart. We can't think, y'all know I always say, well, okay, this is Noel talking when it's just me talking. But if we want to be in line with what God said, we can't talk about what Noel going to do. We can't say what Pastor Cedric going to do. We got to say what would God do. A lot of times I feel like we need to start beginning to take that saying, how people say, what would Jesus do? We need to take that literally. Because people say it figuratively and they say it because it's like a slogan. It's like, yeah, just a little saying to say. No, we need to really be saying, what would Jesus do?
Yeah.
Don't say nothing until in your mind you go through it and say, what would Jesus do right now? What would Jesus have me do right now? Right now, because you got to have your heart in alignment. And I'm praying right now in the name of Jesus. If your heart is not in line with the word of God right now, I believe right now, if you receive it now, that spirit will break up off of you right now in the name of Jesus, and you will begin to line your heart up with what the word of God says about you and your life. Amen. Because it's important. It's a heart thing. Out of the heart is what flows out of your mouth. So whatever's here is going to come out here. Even if you don't say it, if you think it, you might as well say it. If you thought it, just say it, because it's the same thing. Amen.
So that brings you to our next point. So once you get your heart right,
yes.
Now you can get your mouth right.
Yes.
So the one is heart to heart, getting in alignment. Now is get your mouth to mouth in alignment.
Yes.
And in just like CPR, what did God do? He breathed life into your
Lord
lungs, to your mouth. So when God's breathing life into your words, you're bringing back out what he's speaking into your life.
Yes. Amen.
That's why he was saying you can now prophesy.
Thank you, Jesus.
Check this out. The prophet is a mouthpiece for what? God.
Amen.
So guess what? Everyone's prophets. Everybody's prophets. What are you speaking?
Jesus.
Power and death is in the power of the tongue.
Mm-hmm.
What you speak is what you will have. What you speak is what you shall receive. I'm just so tired. I agree with you in the name of Jesus.
Jesus.
Them people always doing me bad. I receive that. What you say, you get everything that you say.
Mm-hmm.
Them men don't like me. Them women don't like me. I'm in full agreement with what you're saying. You're prophesying what's coming into your life.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever you give action to is what you're going to receive.
That's it. That's it.
I can't stand no well. Guess what? I'm going to get that good measure.
Press down.
Press down.
Shake it together.
Shake it together and run it over.
Uh-huh. Indeed.
You can't keep speaking negativity over your spouse.
That's right.
Because you're going to get everything that you're speaking to her.
Jesus.
Especially a strong woman of God, like the Pastor Noel.
You're going to get everything.
I'm going to get everything and a roll in the neck and the hands on the hips and everything.
Coming to you. Everything coming to you.
That's why I say men, be careful, or even women, be careful what you ask God for.
Yep.
You say you want a mighty man of God. Do you really?
You're right. Jesus.
I want a man to take on responsibility. Do you really? But as soon as you get that man, I'm grown. You don't tell me what to do. I thought you just said you wanted a man of God. The Bible says the man is to be head over the woman. And if you're not ready to submit, you're not ready.
Well.
Just stay single. Then you ain't got to worry about nothing. Then there can't nobody tell you what to do.
And furthermore, a real man of God ain't going to let you just talk to him and treat him any kind of way. And you don't want no man that's going to let just going to be a doorman and just lay down and let you say and do whatever you want to do to him either. I know I don't want no man to every now and then. I be trying to get my way, but he be making it hard. But I be like, yeah, okay, then I'm right there. We be like, no, and put his foot down and be serious. And I be like, but then I be like, yeah, that's what I'm talking about right there. Don't nobody want no weak man. Don't nobody want to henpeck they husband no more back. That was back in the day. I don't want no man that's going to let me henpeck him. Because here's the thing. We're talking about alignment, right? We're talking about alignment. That ain't lined up with the word of God. So therefore, if he's not the king of the castle, ain't nothing going to happen for your family the way God said it. Because you're not in divine alignment with what God has for the family. So until the man is the head of the household, for real.
For real, for real.
For real. Your household is never going to receive the full manifestation of what God has for you. Amen. So those promises, don't even listen to them. I'm just saying, because God is a God of order. This is the structure that he put in place.
He did it.
For us to align with the word, that's how it's got to be, y'all. And I'm one of them ones, because when I first got with him, he was calling me up talking about some, you went to Circle K again today? I was like, last time I checked, I was real grown. With you or without you, and I go to work every day. I can spend my money on whatever I want to spend it on. Everything was in a disarray in our household when I was acting like that, though. Till I lined up with the word of God and the way God structures the family. Instead of trying to be misindependent, you don't tell me what to do. And I got into the word, and I got with him. And talk to him, explain to me why you do that. And then I lined up with what the man of God was saying for our household. Now, if I go get coffee, he don't call me and say nothing. But shoot, I got my own coffee now. But still, if I do, he don't call me asking me questions.
Amen.
And we are doing what God called us to do.
Amen.
And we ain't arguing, fussing, and fighting. The little stuff that we fall out about don't even have nothing to do with us.
Just disagreements. Mm-hmm. Amos chapter 3, verses 3 says, surely the Lord God will do nothing, but he will reveal his secrets upon the servants the prophet.
Amen. So,
go ahead.
So nothing is done in the kingdom until something is said.
Mm-hmm. So our mouths must come into alignment when our lives come into alignment.
That's
it simply
right.
Means that we praise him.
Uh-huh.
Hebrews chapter 13, verse 15 says, you got it? Hebrews chapter 13 and verse 15 says, by him, therefore, let us offer the sacrifices of praise to God continually, that is the fruit of our lips giving thanks to his name.
Yep.
So you must put your mouth in alignment. with what God says and not the circumstances. Mm-hmm. You must put your mouth in alignment to what God says and not the doctor's report. Mm-hmm. You must put your mouth into the alignment on what God says and not the statistics. You must put your life, your mouth in alignment to what God declares in his word.
Amen. Amen. That's the thing. And you know, a lot of people, you know, they say, oh, I'm in the middle of a war. You know what? When we're in the middle of something, it's because we're out of alignment somewhere. If we're in the middle, if we have a lot going on in our heads, if we're fighting and we're getting into it and we're having a lot of spiritual warfare in our lives, it's because something is not in alignment with God's word. We don't want to believe that because we say, oh, I serve God. I believe God. I love God. But if everything's always in a disarray, it's always something. Then something is not in alignment. What God says in our heart, it's like, okay, whatever is supposed to be in our heart, but see, we don't let it resonate inside of our spirit. We just let our mind think for us. So a lot of times, somebody said something to me, and I almost got offended, and I had to check it because I said, no, God. I will never take anything that somebody says to be negative. I'm going to look for the good first before I go negative. Because the first thing I wanted to go is negative. I was like, what's she trying to say? And I said, no, the devil is a lie. I took it like, you know what? That was a compliment. It wasn't an insult. But that's my old way of thinking. Certain things that people would say to me back in the day, I'm going to tell you what it was. When I was growing up, when I was younger, and I don't know what happened, y'all. I just woke up one morning, a size 12. I don't know what happened, okay? I used to be a size 2. A 0, then a size 2. Then I went to a 4 and a 6 and just jumped to a 12. Almost 14, right? So I saw somebody, and she hadn't seen me in a while. Now, see, remember, old mindset back in the day where I come from, if you was like less than a size 10, you had to be on drugs or something because you was too skinny. So I was always too skinny. So to me, if somebody tell me, oh, you looking all, you kind of thin there, I would get offended because I'd be like, excuse you. Because I used to drink Ensure and all of that, drink milkshakes with my food trying to gain weight, and I could never gain weight. So I would get offended when somebody called me thin. So the lady said, oh, yeah, girl, you lost a lot of weight, girl. And I started welling up for a second. And then the next, but see here, I could have blocked it all out. The next sentence was, but you look real good, girl. How did you do that? But in my mind, the enemy tried to take me back to where my heart used to be in that area. And I had to check myself and I said, ooh, I thank you, Lord, that I didn't go off on that woman. Because back in the day, I would have went off on her. As soon as she said that first sentence, she wouldn't have got the sentence. She would have never got to part B because I would have went off on her and told her something going up that way, back down that way, and around again. Mm-hmm. Out of your heart is what you speak. It's very important to keep what God says in our hearts and in our minds. Because I could have made a big mess, and it was a church lady. It was at a church function, and it wasn't ours. So that would have been even worse. And then, you know, the cussing spirit be trying, but it didn't come up on me that time. See, that show you when you grow, because the first thing that used to come in my mind was the cussing thing. A cuss word will come up even though I won't say it, but the cuss word would be the first thing. But that's how you know that you're growing, because it wasn't. It was all love.
Like we said. She had to get it out of her heart, what? Mm-hmm. Then had to deal with her mind. Because mm-hmm. the mind is designed to doubt. Mm-hmm. So sometimes you're battling from your heart to your mind, you're battling those mm-hmm. two areas.
Yep.
And let's check this mm-hmm. out in James chapter 1, verse 5. James chapter 1, verses 5. It says, if you need wisdom, ask our generous God, and he will give it to you. He will not rebuke you for asking. But when you ask him, be sure that your faith is in God and God alone. Mm. Do not waver, for a person with a divided loyalty is as unsettled as a wave of the sea that is blown and tossed by the wind.
Jesus.
Such people should not be expected to receive anything from the Lord. Their loyalty is divided between God and the world, and they are unstable in everything that they do.
Jesus.
So you got to make sure your heart and your mind and what comes out your mouth is not divided.
Amen. Yeah.
They can't afford to be divided. They all got to say one thing.
That's good. That's it right there. Because the loyalty comes from your heart. Excuse me. But the thing is, when you have your loyalties divided from loving God and loving the world, that's why your stuff is in the disarray, because you don't know which one to choose. You know, we talked a couple of weeks ago about what table you sitting at. What table are you sitting at?
Where your loyalties lie.
Where do your loyalties lie? Are you at the table of the Lord, or are you table of the devil? Because those two are in conflict. So a lot of times, everything, when your mind is going crazy and you got all this stuff going on and you can't even sleep and you got everything going on and you're always on edge and your nerves are bad and you need to take some extra. No. Sit at one table. Stop standing in between. Because sometimes we have one foot this way, one foot that way. You know, standing like this is uncomfortable for too long. Put 2 feet together in one area and stand still. You know how they say when all just stand? Stand on the right side.
So you got to make sure your loyalties are not what? Divided.
Not divided.
Because once you get your heart right, get your mind right, that what comes out your mouth, the next thing is what you see. Next point is what you see.
Right.
And that's eyes to eyes. Because what? Words create images from the words that's coming out your mouth.
That's right. That's right.
Words that's coming out of your mouth is what gives you vision. So we paint pictures with our words. Why do you think that they put all these big banners and signs out? Because they know if they can get you to see something, they can get you to do anything you want.
Yep.
Same thing, like they show them big burgers on TV. Guess what they're showing? They're showing you something that they want you to have. And you still do it, whether it's healthy or not. You eat certain things, they put in the billboard signs, the lawyers. Everyone knows that the lawyers are taking everybody's money. But what do they got all them signs now on the streets now? By lawyers. Accidents.
Right.
They're programming us now to have accidents on these streets.
Wow.
They're programming us now to get a divorce. Because it's all you see now on those big billboards is divorce lawyers and accident lawyers and food. So if they can get us to get it in our eyes, in our vision,
Jesus,
that's going to get into our mouths and get into our mind and then to our hearts. And once it gets into your heart and your heart's not in line with God, guess what? It's going to go back to your natural side. That's why you got to choose what side are you are you loyalty to?
Amen. That's it right there.
Because if you're loyal to God, that stuff, it's going to come back out because God's going to say, you know what? I came in and gave you everything that you need inside your heart. Remember, your eyes create images.
That's right. And sometimes you can have it and you could just have something in your mind so much that your eyes will create an image that's not even true. And that happens a lot. And we have to start looking at these things because sometimes things, we'll think something happened, we'll think somebody did something or said something or what, and it's not even what's going on. Because your mind is already set that this is what's going to happen. Already set. Because sometimes we even allow ourselves to be affected by other people's ideologies and philosophies. Not what the Word of God says and not what we've studied out. With the word, we listen to other folk and they don't even know what they're talking about. Sometimes we listen to people that don't even know God and let them tell us, let them form something in our hearts and in our minds so that way we begin to visualize what they're telling us, which is not even there. You ever been driving down the road and you've been driving for a while and it's real clear and everything, and all of a sudden you see, it looks like there's water in front of you, that mirage that you see. That's what happens when you allow people to be telling you things that you allow to get in your mind. You allow things to get in your heart. Then you start talking like them. And then you start seeing what they see instead of seeing what God sees. It's the same thing when you're driving. And then, you know, when you're driving, you're seeing that mirage. Sometimes you just got to blink your eye a couple times.
And keep moving
and
forward.
And then keep going. And then it'll go away. So some people, you just got to blink your eyes and tell them, get on out of here. Blink your eyes. That ain't what the word of God says. Don't talk to me. Shut up, because that's not what the word said.
Amen. So when you align your vision, when you align your heart with your mind, when you align your mind with your mouth, and you allow your mind, your mouth with your vision, now you can produce unity. Now you can produce unity.
Yes.
Now you can produce focus.
Yes. Yes.
Now you can produce strength.
Yes.
Now you can produce intensity in your life.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
This is why God says we need to align our hearts, our mouth, and our vision.
That's right.
Because once we align all those, now we can have hand-to-hand contact. You remember how people say when you touch this? When I grabbed Noelle from her father, I had to have what? Hand-to-hand contact.
Because
without hand-to-hand contact, I cannot receive her to me.
Amen.
I can see her. I can have her in my heart all day long. I'm watching her come down the road. She's in my heart. Coming down that aisle, she's coming into my heart while she's coming down. I got her in my mind now because she's looking, oh, my God. I see the vision, man. She looking good coming down this thing. But until I what? Receive her with my hand from the Father.
Amen.
Receive her with my hands. Now I can receive her. Now I can do what God's called me to do and be a happy married couple.
Yes.
So God's saying the same thing with your life.
Yep.
Until I can receive you with my hand, saints of God, you got to give me your hand.
Come on now.
That's you got to give me your hand. If you ain't giving me your hand, ain't nothing I can do. You
That's
can pray.
Right.
You can do a lot of stuff with me. But until you give me your hand.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Give me your hand. Because Jesus. Until you put all those pieces together, you can't function properly.
That's right.
Everything is out of line.
Thank you, Lord.
I want to see someone walk like this, and tell me how far you're going to get. I want to see you try to write without no hands. It's uncomfortable. You'll be doing this, or you're probably doing with your fingers, your feet. That's uncomfortable. That's not the proper alignment on what God established us to be like. I want you to try to do something without seeing. Try to live your life without seeing something. That's things out of function. Try to live your life without a pancreas, out of liver. That's not the original design that God provided in your life. We all need, that's why it's important for everybody to come together as one.
Yeah.
Whether you're white, whether you're black, whether you're Hispanic. No matter what culture you're from, no matter what denomination you're from, it's all about becoming one.
Thank you, Jesus.
When we become one, that's how we can become strengthened together.
Yes, that's good. That's good.
There's something that I like to say in 2 Kings chapter 4 and verse 35. Because now that's how we're going to become blessed. When we become aligned, that's how the blessing is going to come upon our lives. And I'm not saying financially. Blessings means anything.
Yes.
Huh. Blessings means anything.
Right, because you can have finances and still can't sleep at night.
Amen. So in 2 Kings chapter 4 and verse 35, it reads.
It says, he returned and walked back and forth in the house and again went up and stretched himself out on him. Then the child sneezed 7 times and the child opened his eyes.
So the principle of this scripture is he showed that he had to pace himself and pray.
Amen. So you want me to give a background or not?
Go ahead, give background, baby.
Okay, so quick Reader's Digest background version of this. So this is in 2 Kings. This is the the prophet Elijah, he went to the woman, he went to the Shunammite woman's house, and she had a son. He had already been to her house previously, prophesied this son to her. Then when the son manifested, the son ended up dying. He went out to the field. I'm going to say heat stroke maybe. He stroke out there with his daddy. He told his daddy. The daddy had him take him home. He died in his mother's arms. Okay. So then she said, well, hold on a minute. She laid him down because he had a house. Okay, back then they had a house. In their house, they had a room set up for the prophets when the prophets come, so the prophet could have somewhere to lay his head. So she went and laid her son on the prophet's bed, and then she went out to go see the prophet. They prophesied this to her. You told me that God said this. I told you, don't be telling me something that ain't going to happen because I ain't got no kids and I ain't thinking about no kids. But now you done told me this happened. I'm coming to you because now he gone. So she goes to him. She goes to him, and it wasn't even in season to go, but she went. So he sent somebody. He sent his staff, and they said, put it on his forehead. It didn't work out. So she said, I'm not leaving till you come with me. You come with me. So he went with her, and what happened was I said Reader's Digest version, didn't I? So what happened was he got there. When he first arrived, he laid himself hand to hand, eye to eye, and mouth to mouth on top of the boy's body to breathe life into him, to align himself, his life, his anointing with the boy. And the first time he did it, it didn't work.
Mm.
Didn't work. So he went. He said, well, okay, we're going to do it again. But what happens is he went on and did it again. And see, this time he went first. He said, okay, I'm going to go back and forth. I'm going to pace a little bit. I'm going to pray and I'm going to pace a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
And then when he did it again, that's when the boy sneezed 7 times and opened his eyes. So that's the background. Okay. Now
amen.
Go
amen.
And pick it up.
Hey. Now, how many people know you got the hare and the rabbit, right? Sometimes what is the rabbit trying to do all the time? The rabbit's trying to run fast. But guess what? The turtle knew how to pace itself for the end result.
Come on. Yes.
Sometimes us as believers, we're trying to get to the destination soon, and we're not ready to pace ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
So if we sometimes take ourselves and pray,
right,
and pace ourselves,
right,
pray and pace ourselves, pray and pace ourselves, watch God do some things in our lives.
That's right.
But sometimes what we want to do, we want to get to the finish line so quickly where we didn't even get time to pray.
Mm-hmm.
God said we got to pray and pace.
We got to pray and pace.
So, and if we pace ourselves, we won't go out of breath.
Right. Yep. That's true.
We won't be out of breath because we pace ourselves.
Pace
we know our bodies.
Yes.
We know what we're built to do.
Yes.
The rabbit got to the finish line and lost his endurance.
Yes.
And at the end of the road was the turtle ended up winning the battle.
Yes.
So sometimes you got to get to the point where you're learning how to pace and pray. I know I got my uncle, one of my mom's brother. He had got hooked on some, somebody put some in his drink, a Mickey in his drink. And so I remember seeing him as a kid, and he's still alive to this day. All I see him is pacing.
Mm.
He's not waiting on nothing. Mm-mm. It's just his life just keep moving. All he does is do this every day. He gets his cigarette and he just pace.
Mm-hmm.
I'm looking like this man about 80 years old and he's still smoking cigarettes. But all he do is pace. Pace. Why is he 80, almost 90 years old, still living? Because he's exercising. He's doing everything he's supposed to be doing. He's pacing, but he's just not praying, but he's pacing himself for life. So if you just keep moving in life, what God told you to do, as a pace that God set for your life, don't try to rush the process.
Stop rushing the process.
Everybody, people don't understand. Alfred Jr. and Pastor Noel, how are y'all doing it? Because we're pacing this thing. We ain't trying to go and try to do what every other church is doing. I would love to have 100,000 people right now. I would love that. But guess what? We're pacing and we're praying.
Come on.
That God's going to show us the increase.
Hallelujah.
God's going to be in this.
Yes.
Everything that we do, if it's not correct, we can correct it now before we get larger. I don't want to have it. And also we find out later on there was mess because we didn't pace the situation.
We didn't pace. Amen.
And then we miss it.
Yes.
So that's why we got to be constantly pacing and praying.
Pacing and praying.
Pacing and praying. Noelle's not doing everything I want to do, but all I'm going to do is keep pacing. Noelle, I believe that. I know my wife is a virtuous woman of God. I believe my wife is XYZ. I believe that she cooks. I believe she loves me. I believe. I'm pacing and I'm praying. I'm pacing and I'm praying. I believe my wife is the head and not the tail. I believe that we're the lender and not the borrower. I'm pacing and I'm praying.
Yes.
I'm pacing and I'm praying. I love my wife from the head to her toes. I love her from her hips to her cheek.
Get it.
I love all of it.
Yeah, watch it now.
And I'm pacing and I'm praying. I'm pacing and I'm praying.
Out of the
heart. I'm pacing. I might not receive the full manifestation right now, but I'm going to get the full manifestation because I'm pacing
watch
and I'm praying. I'm not waiting. I'm not wanting to all of it to happen right now. She's not going to be all that I need right now. But I know that God gave me a wife that's going to give me everything that I need.
That's right.
Because I asked it for him and because I paced and I prayed for her.
Everything. Yes.
It's a process.
Hallelujah. It's a process. It's a process.
What's happening to us as believers, we're not pacing and praying.
Mm-mm.
We're asking God for something, but then we just... If it looked like something that I asked God for, I immediately go to it right now.
Jesus.
He looks like the older generation, Billy D. Williams. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to guess what? I'm going to go get my Billy D. Williams.
All right.
But he may look like Billy D. Williams, but his action might be King Kong.
Ah.
You might got the Billy D. Williams look, but Lord Jesus. Yeah, he done exposed some things. You didn't know that, brother, but you looked at the looks. I asked God, "Ooh, this is my husband." Oh, I asked God for this. Oh, yeah, but did you investigate that brother? Did you look at that brother's credit?
Right, you better check it out.
Did you look at his past relationships?
Everything that looked good ain't good.
He's single for a reason.
Don't say that. Now, see, not always. Well, because, you know.
I'm talking about hypothetically.
I know.
Pastor Al got two divorces for a reason. You better check out why Pastor Al got two divorces. You better check it out. And did she check it out? Yeah, she called all my exes and see why we all did what we did.
Sure did. And then when I find something new, I call them to this day and be like, you didn't tell me this.
No, I'm saying, but sometimes we're not pacing and praying. We see the facade, but we're not going into the research.
Mm-hmm.
Like I said one time, man, I was so hurt. I was trying to impress Noelle. My credit score always been like 750 or 800 all the time, all my life. Man, I took Noelle trying to showboat. I took it to my bank account. My credit score was at 430, 415.
Really?
I was so hurt, and that was the first time she seen me cry. I cried like a big
like
old
he
baby.
Up here trying
I ain't
to act
never
like
in my life
man
had no bad credit.
Beating
so you better check his credit.
Like he about to help me out, and I'm looking at him like, you can't even get a loan right now.
That's why you
talking
gotta...
about you going to save me.
You better check that brother's credit out before you say I do, because once you make that commitment... That's yours till death do you part. That's why you got to pace and pray. Take your time. Take your time. Take your time.
Take your time. So that's the thing. It's time. It's time for us to really rise up now and pace and pray. Because a lot of times when we... Another thing, you know what? When you're praying too, if you find yourself falling asleep, get up and start walking while you pray. I know Apostle Craig, he say all the time, when he do a lot of his praying, he be walking. He walks. So just walk. You can walk and pray at the same time. You can if you think you're going to keep falling asleep, because it's important to get your prayer time in with God. You got to spend. You cannot continuously not spend time with God and continue to expect him to keep on delivering you from every single situation and being there coming in the midnight hour every time. Sometimes you got to put something in the cash drawer. You got to pray some. You got to have a relationship. You can't just ask God when you need something. It's got to be a relationship already established for some stuff. But some stuff is big. When the prophet went to the woman's house and laid on the boy, he knew with confidence that God was going to come through.
Mm-hmm.
That don't come from just praying for 5 minutes and falling asleep. That comes from praying and pacing and spending time with God.
Praying
that's
and pacing.
What that comes from.
Praying and pacing.
And that's what we have to start doing, because you know what? The world out there now, they need us more than ever, because so many people are cold to God right now.
Let's be honest. The younger generation.
They're cold.
The younger generation. The millennials. Millennials. How are we going to reach the millennials when we ain't got our prayer life in order? We talking about we're going to reach the millennials. How are we going to reach the millennials?
Yep.
Right now, they don't want to hear God. So guess what we got to do? We got to be in prayer and pacing.
Yes. Praying and pacing. And you know what? And asking God, you know what? God, give me a word for them.
Give me a word
for them. To give to them so they know that you're real. Because the millennials, no, they ain't trying to hear all that. Oh, just come to church. No. Tell me. I need more information. I need more information. You need to be able to speak life into them. Don't make them feel like you're judging them, but speak life into them. And that comes from praying and pacing. Because some people came from backgrounds where that's what you do. You condemn folk. Because that's the background you came from. You may not even know you're doing it. So, Lord, help us right now. If that's something on the inside of any of us in here today or online, we're going to break that spirit off right now in the name of Jesus. Because people don't need to be condemned. All your job is to bring them to the word and let God fix them. That's all your job is. You got one job. Testify about the Lord. Obey God and let God do the rest.
And like we always said, we said a few months back, the moment you judge, that's when you take the decision making out of God's hands.
And you made
yourself Lord.
Jesus.
The moment you judge is the moment you told God he's not doing his job.
Jesus.
And now you the Lord over everyone's
God.
Life.
Whew. Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
So it's not our job to judge. All we do is supposed to bring them to church. Let God do it.
Let God do it.
Let the Holy Spirit do it.
Yes. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Because our youth nowadays is built for excellence now.
That's right.
The youth now is engineered to be more than what they are right now.
Yes.
My goal is in the next few years, we have our older generation too, but my goal is to have this church full of young adults and millennials.
True. That's right.
Yes, God. Yes.
The older generation sets the foundation for the millennials. The millennials set the generation for the youth. The youth set up for the children.
Amen.
And it just be a thing that's just keep repeating.
Yes,
this is just a recurring cycle. But if we're not in unity, like we said earlier, if the body's not in order, the body got to be in place. The body got to be in order with our hearts.
Heart.
With our minds, with our mouths, and with our hands.
Yes. Amen.
We can't do the work of God that God's called us on our lives.
Thank you, Jesus.
Everything got to be in spiritual alignment. Yes.
That's right.
Because as we begin to pace and pray, we now can now plead the blood of Jesus Christ on everything that goes
on. Amen.
We can plead the blood over our families.
Yes.
We can plead the blood over our businesses. We can plead the blood over our marriages, our children, our finances. We can plead the blood over drug addictions.
Yep.
Yes.
That's right.
Even over witchcraft and demonic spirits.
Yes. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Nothing can't handle the power of the blood of Jesus Christ if we have everything in spiritual and natural alignments.
In alignment.
So our church, I'm putting a declaration to us, we must now begin to start pacing and praying.
Thank you, Lord.
Do whatever you have to do in your life. If you say, Pastor, I ain't got no time. Yes, you do. Just refigure your time. What's the most important?
Yep. Got time for everything else.
Come on.
It's amazing.
You may need to walk. Just say, you know what, I'm going to take a 30-minute walk. Just go, even if you go around the corner, just around the block. Mm-hmm. As you walk around the block, just pace yourself and pray.
Mm-hmm.
Do it either 30 minutes before you get up and go, but you got to start reorganizing your schedule. Because you believe in God for healings, but God says, I can heal you, just keep sitting on the couch. Mm-hmm. You keep eating vagabonds, bonbons.
Do they make those? Yes, they do.
Yeah, they still do make bonbons, yes, they do. But God says, I want to move you to a, I want to move you to the next phase of your life. It's time to stop having church every Sunday, doing the same thing over and over, 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 and without any change.
Got to be changed.
But we now have to start pacing and praying.
Pacing and praying.
Pacing and praying.
Amen. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Pacing and praying.
As we get to start pacing and praying, God will now have our hearts, our mouths, our eyes, and our hands. And we can now do that with unity as one. And if we become into unity, watch the world. Now they can see a church. A Jesus church. A God's church.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
And now God can say, now I come from my church. He can now say, I come from my church.
Hallelujah. Yes.
And people are saying, oh, God going to come any day now. Look at the world. And people look at the book of Revelation. Look at it. And people talking about God is about to come. If God about to come, is anybody in unity yet? The book of Revelation shows it, that he's not going to come until the church become without spot or wrinkle.
Jesus.
So we may got another 100 more years. There's probably some stuff that's going on that's about to start setting off. But until we become into the unity, until the church become into the unity, without having all these denominations, all these different churches with all these different races, no, it's all one.
It's all one. One body.
One body.
One spirit.
That church can't operate fully until that church comes together with another church.
And the blood is still red.
And God says, if we just pace and pray and let him do the work.
Amen.
Watch God work.
Amen.
As we begin to walk by faith and not by sight.
Yes, God.
Amen.
Because as we're now walking by faith, we're using everything that God says, because now we're in alignment.
Right.
We're in spiritual alignment. Yeah. We're in natural alignment. That's it. And my last thing is, Noel was saying about prayer is very important, because it's a big thing that what we're doing in life and in ministry. But if we don't have our health in order, you guys.
Yeah.
We're calling God to take us out to the byways and all that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
You be up here preaching, you only can go 5 minutes of preaching because you out of breath. God's like, I can't even bless you because you out of order in your life, in your body.
Amen.
We got to get our bodies in order. We got to put our bodies in subjection. I know me, and I'm working on it too. So it ain't just me. It ain't just y'all too. It's me too. But I can't ask God to do certain things that I'm not willing to put the sacrifice in for yet. Amen. I love, and you know, I've been telling Noel, you got to give me some gravy. Noel looking at me, boy, you don't need gravy. I want me some gravy. Don't just do what I tell you to do.
He'd throw a tantrum if he don't get it. He would throw a whole tantrum.
But I know if I want God to do some things in my life, I got to listen. What the doctors are telling me. Listen to what people are telling me.
Amen.
You want to get off of medicine? Do what the doctors tell you. Eat right. Exercise. The doctor's going to keep prescribing you something just to make them more money. You want to slow them down? Start eating right. If not, you'll be on medicine for the rest of your life.
Because that's what the system is designed to do. Keep you medicated so the pharmaceutical companies can make money.
Amen.
Well, you just helped me out right there on that one. Because, like, okay, so I'm going to tell on myself real quick just so y'all understand what he's saying. So I went to the doctor. Y'all know I be going to the doctor. We all go to the doctor. And they told me, okay, we want you to start taking this medication. And this is the medication that will, it'll stop you from reacting. Because y'all know I be reacting to everything. Everything had me hyperventilating. Everything, every perfume, the smell of fresh carpet, the smell of paint, certain soaps, all that, lavender, all that, everything. So the medication that they want me to take keeps me from responding to everything that I respond to. Therefore, it won't take my breath away. So I've had the prescription filled since Monday. And I have not taken the medication. Because Noelle is thinking Noelle's way, right? I want to do it my way because one of the side effects, I didn't like that. And I was like, ooh, I don't know about that. But it also says below that, but your doctor will determine whether the side effect is worth the risk versus what it will do for your condition. So now I'm like, okay, God. All I have to do is take the pill. All I got to do is stop taking medication and try it, because this could be one pill per day and I don't have to be breathless half the time. But yet, I've been asking God, God, when is my manifestation coming? I've been believing you. I trust your word. I obey you. I follow you. I do everything you ask me to do. Where is my manifestation? That could be a natural manifestation that God has put in place. Because some medications, how do you think they come up with it? Sometimes God gives them the wisdom to come up with things. So I'm asking God, and I'm asking God, and now I feel like, now am I that person on the roof that God sent help five times and they refused it? When all it takes is one pill, I could have took one pill Monday and I wouldn't have been out of breath when I walked in here and smelled the carpet today? I'm telling on myself. So sometimes we have to get outside of our own heads and don't allow negativity to get to us from other people around us. And just do what God told. Now, I've been asking him and asking him, where's my manifestation? I've been waiting. I'm tired of this. You're telling me that I got a word for people. You're telling me that I'm supposed to be telling people what you're saying about them. I'm supposed to be doing this. How am I going to do it and I can't breathe all the time? That's the kind of demand. And I ain't been disrespectful with God, but I'm just being real. I'm telling you, I've been going to God like, hey, and the bell just went off this morning that perhaps until God gives the manifestation fully in my body, this is the key. Sometimes you take medication to get to where God is taking you. But if I'm not obedient enough to just take the pill, how can he trust me with the full manifestation of my healing? Just saying. So I'm hoping that helps somebody today, because I'm going to tell you right now, I ain't going to pretend. Y'all know I got some radical faith, but I was like, hold on now, Lord. Amen. Okay, go ahead, Pastor.
So with that being said, if you say, Pastor, I don't know well, we're going to do prayer first. If you say, Pastor, I don't know well, I thought I was in line. In alignment with God called me to do. And I've been doing things out of order, naturally and spiritually. And also, you believe in God, if you're going to, I know some people got some doctor's appointments this week, so you'd like to come up. If you say, Pastor, I don't know what, I'm ready to make some full commitments to do what I know I'm supposed to do. And I just need you guys to come into agreement with what I need. Go ahead and stand and come up. Go ahead and stand and come up.
Thank you, Jesus. Ooh, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Pastor Noel said, you can't get the full manifestation until you start making some decisions.
That's so true.
You can't get the full manifestations until you start making full decisions. Sometimes some people are asking us to pray for
Jesus.
You. But if you still ain't ready to make that full decision, you're not ready to commit to the situation.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
We can pray for you all day, but until you agree to it and make that full declaration that you're ready to make that full decision to make it happen, what we're doing is obsolete. But you got to make a decision. Say, you know what, today I'm making a declaration
today
that I am ready to stop
Thank you,
what
Jesus.
I'm doing. Pastor Noel made a decision.
Thank you, Jesus.
Over 10 years ago to stop smoking cigarettes. She made that decision. And guess what she did? She stopped immediately. But yep. You got to make that decision.
Sure did.
You can say you're going to stop smoking. Everybody can say you're going to stop. But guess what? You're going to stop. When you're going to say I'm going to stop eating. You ain't going to stop eating. You're going to keep eating the same foods over and over. But until you really make that the full decision, make that decision today.
Amen.
Make that full decision today.
Amen. Amen. And when you make the decision, make the decision for real. Because, see, sometimes we play with ourselves. We play games with ourselves, like he said about me smoking. I used to play games and be like, okay, well, I'll tell you, I do 10 today and I'll do 9 tomorrow. Oh, no, maybe if I just do this and do that. No, just stop. And I never even considered smoking another one. Mm-hmm. Never even went. But I was a smoker, okay?
Yeah.
Cigarettes, okay? I talked about how skinny I was. So, yeah, that's, anyway, make a decision today. Today, whatever it is that I need healing from or that I need deliverance from, I'm going to receive it today, and I'm going to believe that God is going to give me the wisdom to make sure that the full manifestation of it happens in my body, in my mind, and in my spirit today.
Yes. Yes.
Amen. And we're never going to look back, no matter what it looked like the next day. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
All right, we ready. Okay, Lord, we thank you so much for the opportunity. Family, we're together, right? We all in agreement together, corporately together, because we are unified at this church. I'm going to get you. Okay. We thank you so much, Lord, for the opportunity to come together and talk about your word. We thank you so much for the opportunity that we can stand together corporately on your word today. We thank you so much for the manifestation of the healing power that you have already on the inside of us. You, by your stripes, we were already healed, Lord. We know that our healing is already there. All we need is the full manifestation of it. And we are believing, God, together today that we can receive the full manifestation of the healing that you have for us, because we choose to walk by faith and not by sight. I don't care what the doctors say. I don't care what it looks like in our minds, in our bodies, and in our spirits. From this day forward, the full manifestation of what you promised is for healing in our bodies, in our minds, and in our spirits shall manifest today. We are speaking life into it today, and we refuse to believe anything else, whatever the enemy may throw at us today. We believe that we are healed. We believe that we are walking in divine health. We are walking in divine healing. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. And then also, I want us all to stand in agreement together with Tanika's having surgery on Thursday. So we're going to all stand in agreement with that, too. Lord, we thank you so much for the opportunity again to come together. We thank you, Lord, that when the woman of God goes under, when she goes in divine, the angels have already started the path for her. So when she walks in there for the surgery, from the minute she walks in the door, she'll be comfortable. She will go in there, and the doctors, you have already touched the doctors' hands and their hearts and their minds that are going to operate her in the name of Jesus. There will be no complications in the name of Jesus. Everything will line up in her body like what the word says about her and her body. We say right now in the name of Jesus that any disease that's trying to take over her body is rebuked right now in the name of Jesus, that we stand against it and we say that it will be gone. It shall be outside of her body in the name of Jesus, because nothing can live inside of your people's bodies unless. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. We thank you that she is healed in the name of Jesus. She's going to go in for one surgery, but she's going to come out with manifestation of something else in the name of Jesus as well. We believe it and we receive it right now with her. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
And the word of the Lord was,
thank you,
what?
Lord Jesus.
Pace,
I'm hot.
And you pray.
Just pace and pray.
That's
no matter
today.
What it looks like, no matter when you wake up in the morning, if that thing is still on you, that's what's going to happen. You got to still believe God and say, the devil is a lie. I receive my healing on today, and that's the word I'm standing on.
Pace.
No matter what.
And pray.
Just pace and pray.
Be like,
ooh,
the turtle.
Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Be like
Jesus.
The turtle. Pace yourself. Amen.
Amen. Thank Amen. You, Jesus.
So what we're going to say now is,
thank you, Jesus.
Is there
thank
any
you.
Non-believers here today? You're going to do good stuff. You say, Pastor, I don't know. Well, today, you know, there's some things that's going on in my life that I know I need to get right. I'm ready to make a full decision now to get myself in alignment. To not just live on the devil's side. Not just live between the devil and God. Because then I can't, because God still can't do nothing. But I really want to be on God's side. And you say, Pastor, I'm ready to be on God's side. You say, Pastor, I don't know. Well, I'm ready to make that full commitment. Yeah, I'm not going to be perfect. Yeah, I'm not going to do anything. But I'm ready to make a full commitment to at least pace and pray on what God's calling my life. You say, ready, Pastor, I don't know. Well, I'm ready to make that full decision. Go ahead and raise your hand. Go ahead, raise your hand. Amen, 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 amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
If you say, Pastor Al Noel, today,
hallelujah.
I'm ready to rededicate my life. I fell away for a minute.
Hallelujah. Thank
I fell
you,
away.
Jesus.
I fell away thank for you, a minute. Lord. I thought I knew what I thought I knew, but I found out I didn't know.
Thank you, Jesus.
I went out there, it's the same old, ain't nothing changed.
What
but
now?
I'm ready to get back, get myself ready for what God's called in my life.
Jesus.
Do I know what God called in my life? No, but I'm ready to find out what God's called in my life. So I'm ready to make that decision to come back to Christ. You say, Pastor Al Noel, today I'm ready to make that full decision to come back to Christ.
You,
go ahead and raise your hand. Amen, amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
If you say, Pastor Al Noel, today I'm ready to receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. The gift of the Holy Spirit
thank
is not
you, Lord,
spooky.
Jesus.
It's not nothing where you're going to do a whole lot of extra stuff. The gift of the Holy Spirit is just a comforter. It's just another tone, it's another speech that you speak to our Father God. Just another way how you can say, you know what, you can talk naturally and you can talk spiritually to him. You say, Pastor Al Noel, I'd like to receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. And maybe you're not understanding, but we do have some awesome elders here and awesome ministers here that can actually teach you on why it's important for you to receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. Say, Pastor Al Noel, I'm ready to receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. Go ahead, raise your hand. Amen.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
If you say today, after today, you came to I Am Church today, whether you're online or in here, if you say, you know what, I came to I Am, I've been here for a few weeks, a few months, or even a few years. Or if you say, you know what, or today's my first day. But I say, I like what you guys are doing here at I Am Church. I like to get connected, to get with some people with like faith. I like to get to where, remember how we talking about, Pastor, we were talking about in the beginning about being a part of that Kool-Aid. The more you put some of us believers in your Kool-Aid, believe me, all the other friends going to start flaring out piece by piece. And now you become a part of what the I Am family is about, where we love to do life and ministry together. Where you'll start having a lot of love in your life. Amen. So you say, Pastor, I don't know what, I like to be a part of ministry and life at I Am Church.
Thank you
say,
Jesus.
Pastor, I don't know what, I'm ready to make that full declaration. Go ahead and raise your hand.
Amen. Thank you, Lord
so
Jesus.
So we don't want to embarrass no one, but if you like, all we ask you to do is just come up. We're not going to embarrass you or nothing. If you like to just come up, amen.
Thank you,
just come
Jesus.
Up. We're not going to embarrass you, but if you like to stay seated, one
thank
of our
ushers
and greeters will come and meet you later on. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, sir. Yes, sir.
Praise
thank
God.
You, sir. Thank you, sir. Appreciate you, sir.
All right. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen, amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. Look, y'all, we're getting men again, y'all.
Hallelujah.
We're getting men again.
Hallelujah.
We're getting men. I heard a saying this week. God is going to start replacing fathers with fathers. Hallelujah. God's going to start bringing fathers back to the church.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
God's going to start bringing fathers to the church.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
And I'm surprised that God brought men in today.
Thank you. Hallelujah.
He said this generation is searching for fathers.
Ooh, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
And he was saying, and a child was talking to his father, and a child was telling his father, he was trying to tell his father something, but his father told him, go talk to your mama.
Oh, Jesus.
But the father forgot his place.
Jesus.
The father forgot his place because as soon as he told the child to go see his mother, he forgot that he was a head. And if the child listened to the head and he gave it to the mother, that means the child got what? Out of order. Because now he's listening to the mother. But if he goes back to the father, and this is what the father says, then we can do what God's called us to do.
Amen.
So God is going to bring fathers back into the church.
Thank
that we're
you,
going to
Jesus.
Be an example to
hallelujah.
The body of Christ.
Yes.
Not saying mamas can't do it. Mamas can do it. That's why we got praying mothers in the house.
Hallelujah.
We got a lot of praying mothers. I remember growing up, we had a lot of praying mothers. Praying mothers is what got us to especially me, Alpha Junior. If Alpha Junior can be up here, that means I had a praying mother praying for me somewhere.
Amen.
Lord Jesus, Alpha was special.
Still is.
And still is.
Amen, Jesus. We're
so just know,
in God's eyes.
Just know, a father. Yes. It's time for us fathers to take our rightful positions and quit sending them back to the mothers. Amen. But if we take our rightful position, they can get into line with us, then we can send them back to the mothers then.
Thank you,
and
Jesus.
And God can do what we called us to do. Amen?
Amen.
So I'm proud of you guys, men, for stepping up, taking your rightful place as kingdom men.
Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
And all I ask you to do is watch God work.
Amen.
Take your time. You ain't going to be perfect overnight.
Yeah.
Just pace and play. Yeah. Pray.
And pray.
If you don't know nothing, all you got to do is just keep pacing. God, I don't know what I'm doing. But just help me, God.
Thank you, Jesus.
God, just help me out. Just keep pacing. Watch God work, man. Tell you. Watch God work.
Thank you, Lord.
Let him work on you. Stay faithful. Stay committed.
Thank you, Jesus.
Just do what God calls you to do. Just
That's
keep
right.
pacing. When you don't know, just walk outside. One of my things I did growing up, I was pacing. I didn't realize I was pacing. I was up and down basketball courts, pacing, studying how to pray the game. Study the word. Get into the word and watch God work on your life.
Amen. Amen. Thank you,
watch
Jesus.
Watch God work on your life. Amen. And we at I Am Church, we're going to love on you.
Yes.
And we have awesome ministers. We have awesome men of God that can help you. Pastor Cedric. Pastor Miles, we're all our men. A lot of my men is out here today, but I'm telling you, we got some awesome men that'll help you guys out through the process.
Yep.
Help you out through the process. And me, of course. You know what I mean? My number is always available. Morning, noon, and night.
Yes, Jesus.
Amen. But we'd like to say thank you guys for doing your part.
Yes.
And today we'd like to say thank you for doing what God's called you to do. And we know that today we got the heart now. We got your minds. We got your mouths, and now we're going to give you the right hand of fellowship. Amen. The right hand of fellowship. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you.
Amen.
So with that being said, we have some classes for you. We have elders who are going to come and see you following service today, and they're going to take all your information. Amen. Amen. God bless.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen. Well, now it's time to rejoice, y'all. It's now time to receive our tithes and offerings. Amen, 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 amen.
Amen.
So there's different ways to give. You can go to our church app, amen. You go to our church app. You can also go to Zelle. If you like to do a Zelle, you can Zelle. Our telephone number is 602-332-0837. You can text the gifts to the I Am Church Online to the number 77977. If you are online, you say, you know what, Pastor, I don't know, well, I don't like doing all the technology, but I like to mail. I like to mail it out to you. You can mail it out to P.O. Box. 1356 Maricopa, Arizona, 85139. Amen. If you are in the house, if you like an offering envelope, you can go and grab an offering envelope. Miss greeters will pass you an envelope. If you can, make sure your full name, your address, your telephone number, email, everything is updated, because we like to always stay in communication with you. Amen.
Amen.
We like to always stay in communication with what's going on in the house. Amen. To see what's going on? Amen.
Amen.
If you have all that done, let's go ahead and stand and do our offering confession of faith. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
You ready?
Amen.
Here we go. Heavenly Father.
Heavenly Father.
I profess this day unto you.
Profess this day unto you.
That we have come into the land.
Come into the land.
In which you provided for us.
Which you provided for us.
As I give. To the kingdom of God.
To the kingdom of God.
With my tithes,
my offerings,
and gifts of love, I know the windows of heaven's blessings
are open for me. I am now blessed to be a blessing with all the financial breakthroughs manifesting in my life for the body of Christ. I live in daily expectation of an exceptional life.
I confess. Unsuspecting people. To go out of their way.
To use their power.
Ability.
And influence.
To help me.
I believe I receive creative wisdom, insight, and opportunities for my life, my family, my business, and my ministry. This is my confession of faith according to your word. In Jesus' name, Amen. Y'all ready? Amen.
We're going to now step on the devil. Step on that devil. Step on his head. Step on it because he's under our feet. We're going to raise our offerings. It's now time to receive our tithes and offerings.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen. You go now be seated and be directed by the ushers and greeters. Amen.
Amen.
Oh,
I think he came up.
Hallelujah.
Can we get this mic?
Number four and number three.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Heavenly Father, we lift up the offering to you in the name of Jesus. I ask you to bless the offering. Bless those that gave it, and bless those that wanted to give it.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. It's throwing you off. That thing. Oh, I didn't know you didn't have no voice. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Pastor Gloria, you said you had something? Is this microphone not working, or I need to get another microphone? Give me another microphone. Come up here.
Thank you, Jesus. Woo. Hallelujah, Jesus is Lord.
Hallelujah. As I was sitting in the back.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
It's the blue. There you go.
As I was sitting in the back, the Holy Spirit said, look around. Look where I brought you all to. Pastor Alan Noel, he said, for your faithfulness and your obedience. He said, the best is yet to come. Continue to do what I have called you to do. Don't look to the left. Don't look to the right. Don't listen to what other people are saying. Continue to trust in me. And I will always lead you in the right direction. God wants us to just worship him today. Can we get some worship music? But I don't want it. I want everybody to stand up. God said, just worship me today for what I've done and what I'm doing and what I'm about to do. Hallelujah. Let's just worship the Lord today. Worship him. Worship him because of who he is, not because of what he's doing, but worship him because he's God Almighty. Amen. Hallelujah. Worship the Lord today. Let's give him glory, praise, and honor because it's due to him. If he don't do nothing else for us again, he's done enough. And continue to keep our pastors in prayer because you know as you go forth and do what God has called you to do, the enemy's always going to try to attack. So we're going to keep them covered in the blood of Jesus. We're going to keep their angels around them. Amen. We're going to be obedient and do what God has called us to do. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Worship him this morning. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. You are great. You are the Almighty God. Monro shata risi. Honda Mahaya. Shandrabo Koro Shata. Hallelujah, Jesus. We love you, Lord. We love you, Jesus. We love you today, oh God. We worship you today, oh God, for your goodness, oh God. For your son, Jesus, oh God. Oh, the Ashanta. Father God, for loving us even when we didn't deserve to be loved. Worship him. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory, glory, glory. Hallelujah, Jesus. Lord, we thank and praise you. We thank and praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oria Shantare. Everybody, raise your hand and say, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. We got so much to thank him for. Oria Shantare. Mondrebo Shanta. Oh, yes, Jesus. Oh, Mahaya. Oh, yes, Sandra.
There's no fear.
Oh, Roshata. Thank you, Jesus. Worship
there
him.
There is no doubt. Cause I have seen your faithfulness.
Hey, hey. Mandro Haya. Hey, go, Shanta. Oh, that's. Oh, thank him. Thank him.
I have a home. Found in your name.
Just worship him. Worship
and
him.
I have a strength.
Just worship him for a few minutes. Let him know you love him. 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 Let him know how much you love him today. Look where he's brought us from. He said the best is yet to come. Not just in our pastor's life, but in our own. As long as we continue to be obedient and trust him.
Do what you are famous for.
Yes.
What you are.
Stretch our hand toward our pastor and let's pray for them today. We're going to speak a blessing over their lives today. We're going to speak that God continue to bless them and that no weapon formed against them shall prosper and that any tongue that rise up against them in judgment shall be condemned. We're putting a hedge of protection around them, sending their warring angels, their guardian angels. We're going to keep them in prayer. Please, the blood of Jesus over them, because they're obedient and they're going forth and doing what God has called them to do. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
More than we ask or think, Lord, you will never.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. No, thank you, Lord Jesus.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Thank
so
you,
this
Lord
week,
Jesus.
We have to decree and declare this
thank
week.
Thank you, hallelujah.
As you begin to go forth this week, that you pace and you pray this week. Start by getting yourself together in alignment to pace and pray this week.
Thank you, Jesus.
Get yourself in alignment spiritually and naturally. Spiritually and naturally. So you can now start pacing and praying for what God's got on your life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Thank Amen. You, Lord. Amen.
Well, we're going to get ourselves prepared to dismiss service today. Amen.
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 Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Well, I'm Pastor Al. And this is Pastor Noel.
Thank you, Jesus. We love
doing ministry and life together.
Yes, we do.
As we walk by faith and not by sight. We'll bring
you
now,
Jesus.
Pastor Cedric Gardner, to just give us
Thank
our dismissal.
You, Lord
benediction.
Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen. Let's give it up for our pastors. Amen. What a word. Pace and pray. Amen. Pace and pray. Hallelujah. At this time, we'd like to dismiss our pastors. Amen. Let's give them a hand. There you go. Mother Gwendolyn, oh, God bless you. God bless you. Anybody having any visitors? First time visitors today? Hallelujah. Heavenly Father, we thank you. We thank you for the word went forth in the name of Jesus. Actually, to bless our going in and our coming out. Bless our sitting down. Bless us when we arise, Father, in the name of Jesus. You get the glory out of our life, Father. You get the glory in the name of Jesus. Now to him that's able to do exceedingly abundantly above more than we ask or think, according to the spirit that dwelleth in us, through Christ Jesus, let the church say, amen. Amen. You are dismissed.